So it is not then a surrendered mind. Surrender is not the imagination of surrender. Surrender is surrender. Don't ever fall into this trap. We try to imagine what it would be like when we are free. Now, being bonded, fully imagining yourself to be in bondage, how can you even imagine freedom? And then you will imagine freedom in terms of bondage because you are the bonded one. Are you seeing this? And then that freedom will appear very scary to you. So the net result will be that you will want to avoid freedom. We all have an image of truth. There is nobody who has no image of God. There is nobody who has no image of freedom. And the image of the freedom prevents you from being free right now. Do you see this? 2 or 3 days back I asked, what makes us reject the God standing right in front of us? The fact that we believe in God. Because you believe in God, you will have an image of God. So you will reject the God standing in front of you. And you will say, oh, I am searching. Never use ifs and buts in these matters. When you say, if I am surrendered, it means that you already know what surrender is. And do you know? Speaking as the ego, do you already know what surrender is? No, you don't know surrender, but you have an idea of surrender. And that idea of surrender is coming from the one who is not surrendered. So that idea will be an idea that will perpetuate and continue the lack of surrender. Don't we ask, what if everybody becomes a Buddha? What do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? No, you can ask this question only because you have an image of the Buddha. And the ego is so arrogant, it tries to have an image of everything. It leaves nothing, spares nothing. Has an image of truth, God, love, everything.
And there it says that theoretically I understand everything.
Theoretically,
and practically I am not able to follow that.
And that's the state of all the learned ones.
Yes.
They say, theoretically I understand. And what kind of statement is this? Theoretical understanding? That is like calling dinner as theoretical food. Will you ever be satiated with theoretical food? Then how can understanding be theoretical?
That's just a deception.
Such a great deception.
And the believing in God or the not believing in God, isn't it just exactly the same? Just
same, exactly the same. Concept? Wonderful, very well said. The believer and the atheist are brothers. One believes in something he does not know, one does not believe in something he does not know.
That's right.
But both are very certain of their belief.
Yeah.
Both are very certain of the belief. God never knows God. God has no conception of God. Only ungodliness knows God a lot. The believers, they have so many books about God and so many fairy tales. And the atheists, they have so many arguments against God, as if they know God at all. Go to God and ask, what is God? Never heard. In fact, you will have to educate God about God. God is totally ignorant about anything called God.